good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Myself, Ruben Ignatius, and he is my colleague, Swaminathan. We are from Visteon Technical Service Center, and we are from Supplier Quality Function. So this is my project title, Curved Glass Foreign Material Defect Reduction from 7.7% to 3%. So this project, we did it at a supplier end. For confidential reason, I'm not revealing the supplier name and the program name. But this is done to our prestigious customer, BMW. So myself, the BB candidate, and these are my team members. So my support team is internally, I have Swaminathan and Karunamurthy. And again, the supplier representatives, few people was helping us in doing this project. So this is the problem statement. The foreign material defect, the foreign material defect is the top failure mode. It is contributing to total scrap of 7.7% in different processes like inkjet, AR, final inspection. It is impacting the yield and shipment. So our objective is to bring this defects from 7.7% to 3%. That is our objective statement. And so the critical to quality is we need to meet the quality of the part that is free from foreign material and the demand requirements. So the total cost savings by doing this is close to approximately comes around $1.1 million. And we have some intangible benefits like line stoppage, customer dissatisfaction, new business wins, etc. And we have the in-scope. It is specific to this curved glass, and other programs can be just replicated the same actions whatever it did for this project. And this is the internal customer, and the external customer is the OEM, that is BMW. So this is the overall time plan. So we kickstarted this in the month of March 2019. And we were able to complete in less than 20 weeks. That is by July middle, we were able to complete this. So different phases are just put on down. So this is a Pareto chart which tells about why we have chosen this project. This foreign material defect is coming as the second failure mode. Close to 3795 parts were getting rejected in the final inspection. Again, I think the product cost and all I'm not revealing here, it is just mentioned confidential, but the overall cost savings is $1.1 million. So this is the high level process mapping. So the incoming raw material forming takes place. The forming is not a flat glass. This is a curved glass basically. So this is a new technology this supplier is doing for the customer BMW. Next is the cutting process. We have anti-glaring process. Inkjet printing layer 1 and layer 2, and anti-reflective process and anti-fingerprinting process, final inspection and dispatch. So I think the rough cut, optical bonding and washing process I'm not included in the overall process map, since I think we are yield is close to 100%. So moving on to the measure phase, this is the data collection plan. So we used to get the daily report from the supplier. So the data collected was from 1st Jan 2019 to 24th March 2019. Week number 1 to week number 12. So we had the data from stage wise at each individual process, at inkjet 1, inkjet 2, AR process, final inspection process. So this is the data collected thing actually. So we did a MSA study to understand how the quality inspectors are able to check the final foreign material defect. So the you can see the kappa value is greater than 0.75. So it is very reliable within across the inspectors. So this is a stage-wise the foreign material defect in the inkjet 1. This is in inkjet 2. In inkjet 2, I think we can see the foreign material defect is slightly high. We can see some spike here. And in AR process, it is mild. And again, the final inspection, the foreign material defect is very high. So this is the trend. So week wise, I have just put the trend here. So the baseline comes around 7.7%, and my target is to bring it to 3%, less than 3%. So this is the baseline data. So moving on to the analyze phase. So we had a brainstorming session with the supplier representatives, and I just listed out all the probable causes that comes as a result of the brainstorming. So I just put in the just categorized in the 4M machine, man, material, methods. So these are all some of the yield, probable causes that results in the high form material defect. So categorization of the form material defect, again I have just put down what are the form material defects we get in the different process. This we get in the lint is one form material defect. Again the adhesion and the lamination, you can just see a sticky material that comes into contact with the part, it produces these types of defect. Any lint or any dust that flies, it gets caught in this adhesive thing actually. And these type of printed defects we get in the final inspection. And again, this is something, the AG layer, that is the backside of the curved lens. So I have categorized the 240 samples. We just run a sample to find out what is the defective cause. Based on the defective cause sheet, we are just able to validate how it occurs in the different probable causes. So again, we have did a Pareto chart to really find the by the 80-20 principle, what are the vital causes, what are the potential causes that comes as a result of this Pareto. So first one is the sticky material peeling off from the number magnet, that is a top contributor, 63%, 63 parts we got. And next one is the ink remover solvent, it's very corrosive, that came as 49. Wiping method, edge and side wiping, it comes around 41. And the heater above glass creates just 17 samples, and sticky material from peeling off film, so 16 samples. So by this, we took the top five causes as the contributor for further investigation. So this is the identified vital causes, X1, X2, X3, X4, X5. So this is the P chart, which tells about actually the, in the methods actually we were having some three causes that was contributing for a higher form material defect. So we investigated and we just did an actually an analysis in this three causes. Next chart. So we did an DOE based upon the three causes. The first one is the traceability number lot with tape and without tape. And the ink remover solvent, previously we were using T40, we tried with this AP11. And the wiping method, edge plus side where we are doing initially, and next we tried with the edge actually. So the T40, back. The T40 actually, this is a very high corrosive thing actually. Whenever the operator touches this wiping T40 liquid, they come into contact with the high corrosive thing actually. It leads to a lot of dust in the peel, the gloves gets peeled off, and as a result I think the dust just comes out of the whenever the operator touches the lens. So AP11 is another liquid actually. This is a low corrosive liquid. We tried this AP11. So this is the DOE trial run. So actually three factors we identified at two levels. So total 8 experiments we did, and the replicate is 5. So we did this by this, since this is an attribute study, we just did by this Oxen method. So this is the main effects plot, and you can see here. So whenever the value of 1.57 is achieved, I think we see that to be the optimized parameters that will be used for recommending the next action. So here you can see that's T40 1.11, sorry, the AP11 is contributed to 1.18, and without tape 0.79, and edge 0.90. This is the main effect. And in the interaction effect, you can see this AP11 is close to 1.33. The value is similarly here. The edge is coming around 1.57. So when you use this AP11 liquid, the without tape and edge, I think we are having some good interaction. So the recommended optimized parameters, what we think is AP11 is having a good, showing good results. Magnetic lot without tape and edge wiping. So this is the recommended optimized parameters. So this is the magnetic lot. Actually, we used initially we used to number it, and we used to have an a tape over it. So, and then we tried with some handmade or some carved thing like that. But later on, we developed this laser marked thing actually. So this was yielding some goodness. There was no corrosion. So again, the good, next slide. The liquid, whatever we used, is AP11. This AP11 is a less corrosive liquid. So as a result, I think the frequency of glove change got reduced. Ultimately, the production also is improved. And this was AP11 liquid was used in further thing actually. And previously, we were using this edge plus side wiping. Now, using this liquid, this AP11 liquid, and this edge only the edge we were wiping. When you wipe the edge, actually, we need to get the custom approval, because whenever the printed ink flows in the edge, it will just, we need to get the customer approval for this. So we got the customer approval for using this also. So this is the action plan that got completed. So this DOE trial, we got completed in the month of June, and this got completed. I'll hand over to Swaminathan.
So in addition to the actions that we have discussed to perform, these are all the other additional action items. So this is the instruction sheet of how to clean the in-dry heater position, and the training record has been established here. The training has been given to the supply representative to clean the dry heater. The additional action items is the cleaning frequency of the oven. So the cleaning frequency, this indicates at which all locations the cleaning needs to be done. Wet wiping inside the oven, the cleaning of the filter, wet wiping inside the doors, the vacuum machine cleaning of inside the oven. And after each and every activity has been done, so the confirmation has been given. So it's essential that this activity has been completed as part of a record. So the other activity is the printing cleaning machine. So this is one of the additional countermeasure. How to do the cleaning of the plasma welding at that location, and the cleaning of the horizontal transfer of the chucking parts, and the cleaning of the frame of horizontal transfer, and cleaning of the flat print. So we have identified different areas where the cleaning frequency and cleaning location has been identified, and relevant records have been established here. And the other activity is the countermeasure for foreign material, that is the cleaning of the plasma location, cleaning of the flat print table, and cleaning of the loading and unloading, and also the machine side, flat print table, and the cover cloth inspection state. So we identify different areas where the cleaning might be more necessary to ensure that different areas are being covered, to ensure that the foreign material defect will be reduced to a drastic extent possible. And whatever actions that I have discussed in the previous slide, we have documented in the form of various causes, what is the root cause, the recommended actions, that's the evidence I have shown, and the relevant training record, and all the pictorial representation that we shared in the previous slides. All these are completed on these respective dates against the target, and with the help of these representative persons at supply location. And additional actions like the countermeasure of the sticky foreign materials. So earlier there is a possibility that because of this aspect or area of concern, the stickiness results in the foreign material defect. So now this has been rectified here. You can see the improved portion of the picture here. Then the countermeasure of the foreign material is the tape addition. This is the earlier tape addition that they used actually. So this is the improved official standard wiping tool with no tape addition material. So this is another improvement. Next is the adhesive material at the door entrance. So at this location, there is more possibility that the adhesive stain is getting embedded into the part, resulting in the foreign material defect detection possibility increase. So we eliminated that adhesive material at the door entrance in the improved picture here. So again, the whatever actions that we discussed in the previous slides, we have documented in the form of matrix with all the costs identified, with recommended actions and improved action plan, with all responsibility and target date. All actions are completed. And we have seen the two proportion test for before and the improved state actually. So against 2220 samples, 170 was the occurrence. And now with the improved actions, we took 4900 samples, and 83 is occurrence of the defect. So we found that H0 is rejected, which means that there is a significant improvement between the previous and the current state or improved state with the implementation of the actions. So the p value is less than 0.05, which shows that improvement is statistically significant. Yeah. Now I hand it over to Rupa.
Thank you, Swami. So this is the MSc study actually we did. Yeah. So after improvement, again, we just want to understand how the operators are inspecting the formative defect in the final inspection. So we ran, we just ran 50 samples in the final inspection. So we see again the kappa value is greater than 0.75. We see the what are the inspection the operators are doing, it's reliable. So this is the before improvement and the after improvement. You can see that in the month of in the week of 19-20, we just did a few actions there. There was some slight improvement. So when we did this DOE completely, so the DOE resulted in really bringing down this defect drastically. To it is close to now, it is close coming around 1.5 or 1.2%. So this knowledge was shared to the foreign material defect team, and we received appreciation from the global team also. So this is the final summary. We have used some Six Sigma tools like in the measure phase, Pareto trend chart, and the analyze phase, brainstorming, cause and effect diagram, MSc attribute study, the DOE in the improve phase, and it was shared to the global team as well. That's it. Thank you.
So you are, my understanding is slightly wrong, might be wrong also. You are looking at dust, correct? What are the sources of dust? What is internal to the process? What is external to the process? Okay, I'll finish off my questions. What way it is related to that AR pinhole project? Because this is also the same process. Okay? Because one, dust, so how do you measure dust? Do you have some particulate measurement, like they say, no, air quality index, AQ, PM2.5, some PM100. What are the dust distribution before? What are the dust distribution after? This is related to the project. And is dust the only foreign material? So I have a lot of queries. I don't expect you to answer all of them in one shot. So these are related to this. Because is your primary interest dust? What is a foreign particle? Definition of a, that is what I expect in this define.
Because foreign material, I think, we cannot cover the entire thing initially. However, we see that, work on the dust actually. Any particle, the dust actually, whatever it is, you know, the sticky material, the printed material dust, the low dust.
Yeah. Ah, so yeah. that is why I said so sources of dust. So if, sorry if I am just repeating, because when you say sources, no, what is internal to the process? I am using a glove, source of dust. I am using T40, some cleaner you are saying, no, source of dust. Each thing source adds. So some nice, I am not commenting, the flow would have been easier for somebody to understand. This is one thing in respect to your presentation. Other thing is two inputs I want to give to the earlier DOE team also, whoever presents DOE. Whenever you present DOE, if there is interaction, do not look at the main effects. Interaction means a combination of factors gives better results. So main effect graph has no meaning when you have interaction. So all of you are counting the main effect. I never look at it at all. So even that first team, which I think AR pinhole, say AM problem, they're all, when there's, that means your understanding of DOE should be clear. DOE says if there is interaction, a set or a combination of factors will, okay? Same, any chart without limit, not acceptable. Most of your charts have no control limit. Always evaluate a process for stability. You are showing many charts. Where are the control limits?
What is the selection criteria you're looking for that ink remover solvent, no? So you told one specification T40, another is AP11. What is the selection criteria? How you have selected the T40 and how you have gone through AP11? What is the main deciding factor?
Because previously T40 was very corrosive for handling the, operator uses the part to for handling, that it was very corrosive. When they wiped that in that lens, there was more for the dust that created from the gloves actually. So it is very high corrosive. So AP11 was more of an alkaline type of.
What I'm trying to ask is whether you are monitoring the based on the pH value. That's what I'm trying to understand. Because actually, between T40 and AP11, there should be some change.
Yeah, it is a marketing name. It is a marketing name basically. For the confidential purpose, I'm not telling that right. So, yeah, reveal that actually.
Those technical know-hows of those.
Normally, when these kind of thing, they will give all the technical version. Then safety part of MSDS sheet they will give.
Yes. COC, yeah.
This is T40 AP11. It is one. It is not your product. One person product. Okay.
Yes. Okay. We couldn't share here.
Because deciding factor. My thing is T40 AP11. How certain gone? So you did lot of trial to understand
that
this.
But I told the effects actually.
Maybe T40 or T40 by something.
It is corrosive. This is less corrosive. So that way I classified actually.
Okay. Fine. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.